Hey guys, and welcome back to another video. So in the previous video, I told you how you can actually print some statements in Python. Also talked about importance of comments in whole program. So comments are actually useful. So whenever you're writing some code, you just need to mention comments so that it will be helpful for the other person to understand what sort of logic you have applied for that program. And also I talked about basic introduction to variables. So in this video, what I'll be talking about is how you can actually take input in Python, and also very important concept, or not a concept, so it's just a topic actually. So it's very, very important, that is what exactly the typecasting is and why it is very, very important in, especially in Python language. So typecasting, I'll talk about it. And so there we go. So first of all, we need to learn how actually we can take input from a user. So before that, let me just write the comment, taking input from a user. Okay, there we go. So this is how I can write comment in Python actually. If you have watched my previous video, you can understand how I written this. And now the concept is how actually, the question is, how can I take input from a user? First of all, if I want to ask to any users, let's just say X person is looking my code, and I just want to ask him, or the computer wants to ask him, enter your roll number. So how can I do that is, first of all, we need to declare a variable which will contain the data that is given by the user. And later on, we use this equal symbol. And after that, we just need to write input. And in this double quotes, or even you can use single quotes, you have to write any message that you need to print for the user, asking any question like that. So here I will ask, enter your roll number. My bad, typos. So this is how I can ask a question to the user, asking to give input. So now if I hit enter, it will ask me, enter your roll number. Let's just say I'll give 89 as my roll number, any random number. That's not my roll number actually, so I'm giving any random number. So I have given 89, and now I'll hit enter. Now what happens is, internally, is this roll number variable will contain this 89, which is given by the user. So how I can check that is just by printing this roll number variable. What inside that? Put 89 as an output, because that is actually stored in this roll number variable. So keep that in your mind. This is the syntax that you need to follow. First of all, you need to declare any variable which will contain the data given by the user. And if you want to check what type of data inside that variable, you can just print this roll number. Now the question is, you have entered 89, which is actually, you think it is an integer, right? So you think this is an integer, but if I check what type of data this roll number variable is containing, is you'll actually surprise. So how can I check what type of data this roll number variable is containing is just by putting this just by writing this type and type of roll number. Now if I hit enter, I'll get string, but we have entered integer, right? So what happens here? What's going on? What's wrong with this Python? Is this a problem with the shell? No. Actually, whatever the input you give in Python is actually taking it as a string format. So I told you I will talk about typecasting. So we'll talk about typecasting little later. Let me just explain this concept. So whatever the data you enter in Python is actually will take it as a string format. So even though you have entered 89, which you think that is an integer, but actually it is taking in the format, in string format. Again, it is showing class string. So because this 89 belongs to string class actually. So classes and objects are actually object-oriented concept. So I'm not going to talk about much about classes and that. So this is how actually happens. So keep that in your mind, that whatever the data you enter in Python from the user is always a string data type. So later on, you need to typecast the data based on the program requirement. So now I'll talk about typecasting. So I'll explain what exactly it is and why it is very important in Python language. So there we go. What exactly this typecasting is? Typecasting actually meaning is you want to convert the data type of any variable. So here we have seen 89, which is in the format of string, right? But we need integer format, right? So we have to typecast this 89 variable or this roll number variable, my bad. So this roll number variable, we need to actually typecast and we need to convert into integer format. So how can I do that is just by writing like this, roll number equal to int of roll number. So this int is one class and this is how I can do typecasting. So now if I hit enter, now this roll number is containing integer value. So how can I check that is just by writing type of roll number. Now it will return class int. Definitely because we actually typecasted it, right? So previously 89, which was in the format of string, now it is converted into integer format. So this is how we can do typecasting. We can actually convert that into float as well. Let me show you one more thing. So we can convert that into typecast. We can actually typecast into float format as well. So how can I do that is just by writing like this, roll number equal to float of roll number. Now if I want to check what type of data this roll number is containing, is it will return you class float. So we got class float. So I told you how you can actually convert the data into one format into another format. So this is typecasting and it is very, very important in Python. So directly you can do this. Let me show you one more thing. So now whatever the data you are entering is actually in the format of string. As of now, you understood completely that whatever the data you enter in Python is taken as a string format. Now if you want to typecast here itself, how can I do that? Just by writing like this, int of input of enter your roll number. So now it is asking enter your roll number. Let's just say 67. I have entered a roll number, right? Now if you want to check what type of data this roll number variable is having, is it will return you int, because here itself we actually typecasted it. So whatever the data entered here is string, and again it is typecasted to integer. And now that's roll number variable is holding integer format, which is actually 89 or 67 roll number, which is actually in the format of integer. So this is what the typecasting is, and it is very, very important. That's all for this video. I hope you understood what I explained in this video. And if you still have any doubts, feel free to ask questions in the comment section below. And one more thing, I didn't talk much about data types. I hope you will Google it and eventually you will be habituated for the self-learning process. So I hope you will do, and thanks for watching, and keep share, subscribe to this channel for more interesting tech updates as well as gadget reviews and also for programming related concepts.